Hi, my name is Hanna. I'm an MBA student from Bandung Institute of Technology, Indonesia. Today, I will explain about Chapter 1 from Managerial Economics in a Global Economy by Dominic Salvatore. The first chapter is about the nature and scope of managerial economics. What is managerial economics? Well, managerial economics refers to the use of economic theory and the tools of analysis of decision science to examine how an organization can achieve its aim and objective most effectively. The relationship between managerial economics and other fields of study can be examined with this figure. Based on this figure, we can see that economic theory refers to microeconomics and macroeconomics. Well, microeconomics is the study of the economic behavior of individual decision-making units such as individual consumers, research owners, and business firms in a free enterprise system. While macroeconomics is the study of total or aggregate output, income, employment, consumption, investment, and price of the economic view as a whole. Decision science is referred to mathematical economics and econometrics. Mathematical economics is used to formalize the economic models postulated by economic theory. Econometrics applies statistical tools, primary regression analysis, to real-world data to estimate the models postulated by economic theory and for forecasting. So, managerial economics use the applications of economic theory and utilize the tool of mathematical economics and econometrics to solve managerial decisions problem in order to find the optimal solutions of the problem. The theory of the firm. The theory of the firms consists of a number of economic theory that describes, explain, and predict the nature of the firm's company or corporations, including its existence behavior, structures, and relationships to the market and behavior of a firm in pursuit of profit maximization. Theory of firms are also combined and organized research for the purpose of producing goods or service for sales, internalized transactions, reducing transaction costs. Primary goal is to maximize the wealth or value of the firm. Value of the firm. How do we calculate the value of the firm? To find the value of the firm is by calculating the present value of the expected future profit of the firm using the formula in the slide, where PV is the present value of all expected future profit of the firm. V represents the expected profit in each of the N years considered. And R is the discount rate. Alternative theories. Sales maximization model. The model that postulates that oligopolistic firms seek to maximize sales after an adequate rate of profit has been earned to satisfy stockholders. The next one is management utility maximization. Postulates that with the advent of the modern corporation and the resulting separation of management from ownerships, managers are more interested in maximizing their utility, measured in terms of their compensation, the size of the staff, the extent of control of corporations, leftist office, and etc. This is also referred to principal agent problem. The last one is satisfying behavior. The theory of the firm that postulates that managers are not able to maximize profits but can strive only for some satisfactory goals in terms of sales, profit growth, market sales, and so on. Definitions of profit. Business profit, the amount of available to fund equity capital after payment for all other resources used by the firm, where total revenue minus the explicit or accounting cost of production. The second one is economic profit, the total revenue minus the explicit and implicit cost of production. The last one is opportunity cost, is the cost of any activity measured in terms of the value of the next best alternative foregone or implicit value of a resource in its best alternative. The next one, I will explain about theories of profit. Risk-bearing theory of profit. Higher profit is compensation for investing in riskier endeavors. Frictional theory of profit. This theory stresses that profits arise as a result of friction or disturbance from long-run equilibrium. The third one is monopoly theory of profit. Some firms with monopoly power can restrict output and charge higher price than under perfect competition, thereby earning profit. The fourth one is innovation theory of profit. In this theory, postulates that profit is the reward for the introductions of a successful innovations. The fifth one is managerial efficiency theory of profit. This theory rests on the observation that the average firm tends to earn only a normal return on its investment in the long run. Next, I will explain about function of profit. Profit is a signal that guides the allocation of society resources. High profit in an industry are signal that buyers want more of what the industry produces. Low or negative profits in an industry are a signal that buyer want less of what the industry produces. Business ethics. Business ethics seeks to prescribe behavior that businesses, firm managers, and workers should not engage in. Source of guidance that goes beyond enforceable laws. The changing environment of managerial economics. Global of economic activity requires goods and services, capital, technology, skilled labor, and technological change requires telecommunication advance, the internet, and the World Wide Web. Well, that's all from this chapter. Thank you for listening. Bye.